Hey everyone, welcome to Lachlan Likes a Thing, a show where I take a thing and see whether or not I like it. Now, I managed to buy one of these today. This is the Sony RX100 M3. So this is the third version of Sony's super advanced RX compact camera. And this is one of those rare opportunities being in Australia where I managed to buy something before it's actually being released, at least on Amazon in the United States. So really exciting stuff. Anyway, this is going to be an unboxing video and I'm going to give you some of my brief first impressions of the camera. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comments section and I will respond to them once I've played around with the camera a bit. Anyway, let's get right into it. So I bought this RX100 Mark III from DigiDirect in Sydney and I was helped out by my friend John, who actually works at DigiDirect, and he actually has a YouTube channel of his own. So I'll leave a link to that in the description of this video and you can check that out. I've been very excited about this camera ever since I heard about it, just because this pretty much has every feature that I'm after in a camera. And I'll give you a brief overview once I've kind of unsealed this packing tape. Kind of want to do this properly so it doesn't end up kind of... As you can see, I'm still not great at these unboxing videos. There we go, almost cut my thumb open there, but that is the perils of being a unboxer on YouTube. This is really not proving to be easy to open because of my own terrible incompetence. But, let's definitely open the seal there, so there's gonna be no returning this unit. Okay, so let's... sorry about this. Okay, there we go. Got the seal open there. I'll put those scissors aside. I don't believe we'll need those anymore after opening several Sony cameras in the past. And we just open that up. The RX100 Mark III, if you don't know, is the third in a series of very, very good compact cameras from Sony. These are premium kind of point and shoot cameras, but they have features which really belie their tiny size. So we have here on the top, we have the instruction manual, and notably Sony has put the viewfinder instructions on the top here. If you can see that. And that's really telling because the biggest feature of the RX100 is actually the new electronic built-in viewfinder, which I'll show you in a second. Then we have the Wi-Fi One Touch NFC guide. We have a little pamphlet about accessories you can buy for the RX100. And then the big, thick instruction manual here. All right, so we'll just put those aside for now. Then we can just open up the box. Oh, so very classy. Everything's wrapped up in black paper. Very, very premium. Okay, so that's the camera itself. And then we have the power plug. Then we have the USB charger. So all the new Sony cameras do not come with wall chargers. They don't come with separate battery pack chargers. They just come with little USB adapters, which is a little bit of an annoying thing because honestly, I would like to be able to charge the battery. We have a wrist strap, which is really awesome. I was hoping that they would include one of these. And we have the USB transfer cable. And that's all we have in the box, as far as I can tell. Oh, there we go. We have one more thing, obviously, really important. We have the battery. And some of these things here, I think these are just little tabs for a neck strap as well. So I guess there must be a neck strap in here somewhere, but I don't know where that is. Okay, I guess there's a neck strap accessory that you can buy or something. There's nothing else in this box. Anyway, we'll put everything aside for now, except the battery, which we'll need, and the camera. So move that aside. So just opening this up, and I actually have played around with demonstration units of the RX100 Mark III, but just look at that. It's, as you can tell, it's a very small looking camera. This is an absolute battleship of a camera. And I don't know if it comes across in the video, but just in terms of build quality, this thing feels fantastic. The entire body, I don't know if the entire body, but it feels like most of the body is made out of magnesium alloy, so it just feels very well built.
The finishing on this is fantastic. And I own a Sony Alpha 6000, and I can tell you that the finishing on that camera is not nearly as good as this one. So some of the things that really, really appealed to me about this camera, which was why I got it, or I was very excited when I first heard about it. Firstly, for a small camera of this size, they've actually installed a electronic viewfinder. And you can't see it here. There you go. You flick that switch and you pull out the viewfinder, and then you have their beautiful OLED viewfinder, which I will talk about once I played around with the camera and can give some first impressions. Then also the other standout feature of the RX100 Mark III is this lens. Sony has been very, very excited about the lens they've implemented on this camera because they've managed to fuse together two a spherical optical elements, and that means that we have a f1.8, f2.8 lens, which has a effective focal length from 24mm to 70mm. If you don't know what that means, basically it means that you're going to be able to take really nice sort of wide angle photos for kind of street photography, that kind of thing, with really, you know, being able to get a lot of light at f1.8, but you can go all the way to portrait, and you still get, with 2.8, you'll get lovely bokeh kind of background blur. So it's an incredibly versatile camera, an incredibly versatile lens in that respect. The other thing that I really wanted out of this camera was the 180 degree flip LCD. Now, I know a lot of you might laugh about this because this is kind of for selfies and stuff, but for me making YouTube videos, things like this are fantastic. So that's really another reason why I was super excited about this camera. Lastly, the thing that also really excited me, and I don't know if we have the battery life to kind of show you, but I'll put the camera in. I'm sorry, I'll put the battery in, is that this camera lets you take very high bitrate video files, higher than even my Alpha 6000, and the sensor actually scans every single line from the image sensor. So I'll just set the time. I'll just leave that as the time for now. The image sensor is going to use every single line of resolution, which means less aliasing in full HD video shooting modes, and also it has a higher bitrate shooting mode. And the other thing about this camera is that unlike something like the Alpha 6000 or anything like that, it has a built-in ND filter, which I'll just show you here. Let me just see if I can bring that up. Oh, actually, no, I remember how to do this. We go to function, then we can pull up the, oh, it's not actually in the, must be in the manual mode. Okay, so we go to function, function here, and then we can turn on the ND filter. So what that does, you can see that here, what that does is that it puts on a grayscale filter on the front of the lens, and that means that you can still shoot at wide apertures even in bright sunlight conditions. So you might be able to use this to take pictures of running water, or if it's very sunny outside but you still want to have a relatively sane shutter speed for video shooting, you can do that with the ND filter. So that's the reason why I got this camera. All of these things mean that this makes for a really tiny, compact, but still very, very high quality run and gun kind of camera, which is why it does cost quite a pretty penny. But I'll be super excited about this. And again, if you have any questions at all about this camera, I'll be playing around with it for the next few hours. And just leave your questions in the comments and I will try and get around to answering them. I will probably also have a Google Hangout, just a live Google Hangout to answer any questions about this camera. So if you wanna know when I'm gonna do that, I'll put a link in the description of that video once I've set a time, or you can follow me on our Facebook at facebook.com/LachlanLikesTheThing, or on Twitter at LachlanLikesTheThing. Anyway, I'm gonna be having a lot of fun with this in the next few days. So enjoy the rest of your week.